There are 600 different types of venomous snake, and their bites produce different symptoms. Not all are fatal, but they can lead to complications such as amputation, kidney failure, or chronic neurological disorders. Yet snake bites remain an all too neglected public health issue. Few antivenoms adapted for use in developing countries can stop the effects of multiple types of venom simultaneously. Favafrique, however, is effective against the venom of at least 10 of the most dangerous snakes found in sub-Saharan Africa. It is used extensively by MSF teams in the field. Take Paua in northwest Central African Republic, where the teams treat 300 to 400 people with snake bites every year. The chief culprit here is the Echis ocellatus viper, whose venom is among the most dangerous in the world, killing around 10% of its victims. The mortality rate drops to under 0.5% when antivenom serum Favafrique is administered in time. But between 2016 and 2019, Favafrique will be unobtainable. At the current rate, in Paua alone, over 1,000 patients are in danger of not receiving treatment and suffering serious complications, and 100 of them may even die. To understand why there will be no serum in the upcoming years, we have to go back to 2010. In 2010, Sanofi decided to halt production of Favafrique, viewing it unprofitable. The decision was only made public 3 years later. Sanofi produced its last batch of serum in 2014, which will expire in 2016. A transfer of technology is underway to enable another laboratory to take over production, but the new serum will not be available until 2019. Manufacturing the antivenom is complex. It begins with extracting snake venom, which is diluted and injected into a horse, as the horse's immune system produces antibodies that can then be harvested. The serum is then purified prior to being packaged. The whole process takes about 2 years. It's Sanofi's responsibility to provide a temporary solution in the interim. If production of the serum doesn't start up again soon, thousands of lives will be endangered. But any such solution can at best provide only temporary relief for an unreliable system. The manufacturing process of antivenoms is as archaic as it is inefficient. It's time that more serums adapted for use in developing countries be made available for victims.